Today,
leo,
is a special day for every one of us.
And I
declare it shall be different and you will have an encounter with the Lord. In the name of Jesus. Would you speak for a few minutes? And today we are going to have our miracle
meal.
Some of them call the Lord's
table.
Others call it Holy Communion. And others call it Lord's Supper. So I believe I have captured all the names used so that wherever you have been before and the name has been used, that there will be no confusion. So today we are going to share briefly about the Lord's table. And the Lord will bless us. I know you have been taught about this. I am going to highlight a few things which are critical in the Lord's table.
There
are two ordinances that Jesus left for us. And these ordinances are an exercise that Christians do to emphasize their faith in Jesus. These ordinances do not bring salvation, but it is a commitment to the faith of Christ Jesus.
Yes,
the one time, and Jesus practiced it Mkanibariki mimi pia
This was the original setting of the Holy Communion.
I'm gonna be the same.
preaching the gospel. The gospel of salvation. You are matter. You are sin. You are no longer the same again. When you believe in Jesus, you are mighty for destiny. You are mighty for greatness. You are moved from faith to class. You are taken to another level.
Pigo
mucho
de
parte
de
Faraón,
más
de
listo.
La
droga,
guay,
se
mueve.
Ay,
se
llena.
communion.
Then a joy of the one.
Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God and afflicted.
Continue up to verse 6.
But he was wounded for our transgressions, he was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. Verse 6. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all.
Hakika amechukua masikitiko yetu, na amechipika huzuni zetu. Lakini tulimdhania kuwa amepigwa, amepigwa na Mungu na kuteswa. Bali alijeruhiwa kwa makosa yetu, alichurubiwa kwa maovu yetu. Adhabu ya amani yetu ilikuwa juu yake, na wakupigwa kwa sisi tulipona. Sisi sote kama kondoo tumepotea, kila mmoja wetu akigeukia njia yake mwenyewe. Bwana ameweka juu yake maovu yetu sisi sote. Ilikuwa tuni.
Ilikuwa
good. Mawe ilikuwa
mzuri.
Hakukuwa na haja ya kwenda
Because of sin.
So that someone has not confessed. Because the very sin of death of sin is repentance. There's no way you can even get sleep.
But God created a very simple way.
Bada kaumba mambo mzuri.
Through the cross.
Kupitia kwa msalaba.
Forgiveness of sin.
Msamaha wa dhambi.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Bible says he carried our griefs.
Alibeba masikitiko yetu.
He carried our curses.
Akabeba dhambi zetu.
He carried our sorrows.
Akabeba masikitiko yetu.
Alitoka to the cross.
Alipeleka msalaba.
But it says that it is a state of
Ni hali ya utulivu.
Absence of war. That is in general.
Kukosa vita.
That is peace.
Hiyo ni amani.
But now when we come here,
napokuja,
I find it as the state of your mind that you are assured that all shall be well.
Hali ya kimwili wako kwamba yote itakuwa salama.
Even when things are not well now, you are assured in your mind.
Hata kama sasa si uzuri, ndio hakika kesho. Mambo yatakuwa vyema.
Why?
Kwa nini? Maana Yesu alinipa.
Bible says because we were not supposed to have peace.
Hatukuwa tupate amani.
Jesus was chastened.
Yesu akaadhibiwa.
Akawekwa mtegeti. Hiyo ni amani. Mimi apate amani. Askari akaona haitafikia John, akamweka ingine. Askari akaona haitafikia Maria, akapiga ingine for our peace.
Kwa adhabu ya amani yetu.
Get peace in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. You receive the peace of God.
Prepare money about it.
Bible says the peace of God transcends human understandings.
Money upon it and pizza and kids are one another.
By the virtue of the blood of Christ Jesus on the cross.
For I didn't damn you, Jesus.
And by the chastisement on his body.
Now he had that to walk in your
life. You receive peace.
And prepare money.
There is something where.
It is where.
It is where.
It is where. Yeah. Yesu.
We were him.
Tukapata kupona.
That is the work of the breath of the body of Christ.
Iyo ni kazi ya kufutika kwa mwili wa Yesu.
Forgiveness of sin.
Kuna msamaha wa dhambi.
There is restoration of peace.
Kuna kurudishwa wa dhambi.
And there is healing.
Na kuna uponyaji.
From the strength of the body of Christ.
Kwa mapigo kwa mwili wa Yesu.
In the body of Christ there is forgiveness of sin.
Kuna msamaha wa dhambi.
Transgressions have been taken away.
Kuondolewa dhambi.
And this is the new covenant.
Na hii ni agano
mpya. That the sins will not be remembered anymore.
Dhambi zako hazitakumbukwa tena.
And I will write my law into your hearts.
Nitaandika amri yangu ndani ya moyo wako.
You will not need any man to teach you.
Hautahitaji mtu akufunze.
This is what the Lord prophesies through the prophet Jeremiah.
Hii ndio Bwana akanena na nabii Jeremiah.
That is the new covenant.
Hiyo ndio agano.
Your peace is guaranteed.
Amani yako imenipa.
I said today the peace of your family is guaranteed.
Sema amani yako kwa familia yako imenipa.
In the name of Jesus.
Katika jina la Yesu.
There will be supernatural power today.
Amna Mungu kiongozi sio wa kawaida.
In the name of Jesus.
Katika jina la Yesu.
Let's go to Matthew.
Tabu ya Mathayo.
Jesus, and you are my power.
Now I'm going to shake it. 19.
Yeah.
Examine your life.
Chunguza maisha yako.
If there is any unrepentant sin,
kama kuna dhambi au tatubu,
tell the Lord to forgive you now.
Ambia Bwana kusamehe leo.
Tell God to cleanse your life.
Ambia Bwana atakase maisha yako.
You desire more of Him.
Unamhitaji zaidi.
Bible says, examine yourself.
Inasema jichunguzeni ninyi wenyewe.
Therefore, whoever eats this bread or drinks this cup,
naye kunywa hiki kikombe na kula ugali,
in an unworthy manner will be guilty of the blood of the body and the blood of the Lord.
Njia isiyopendeza atakuwa amekosea damu ya Yesu.
But let a man examine himself and examine himself.
Na wacha mtu ajichunguze yeye mwenyewe.
And so let him eat of the bread and drink of the cup.
Na wacha yeye akule mwili na akunywe kikombe.
Let the Lord forgive and sanctify.
Ambia Bwana akusamehe.
In the name of Jesus.
Katika jina la Yesu.
You are here, and you know very well.
Now that you are here,
that you left God and you backslid.
Kwamba uliacha Mungu na ukaanguka.
Oh, you are not born again.
Ama hujaokoka.
Lift your heart, I pray.
Inua mkono wako tuombe pamoja.
To receive Jesus.
Upokee Yesu.
So you are not born again. Just lift your hand.
Kwamba na hujaokoka, inua tu mkono.
Oh, you backslid and you want to receive Jesus again.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
Thank
you, Spirit.
Thank you, Lord.
Lord, we thank you, we give you the Lord. We are going to take the Lord's Supper.
In Jesus' name.
So I
request
that you did come and take the cup. Pastor, take the bread.
Pastor, take the bread.